Sixers beat the Raptors by 7 points in Philadelphia for their last game of 2020. Philadelphia didn't lose a game at the Wells Fargo Center this entire year. This starts with opening up the offensive playbook. You know me, bro. Let's break it down.
This is some good off-ball activity. Pascal Siakam recognizes Tobias is up to something and Kyle Lowry switching. But ultimately, this design was to get Tobias Harris to drive for a layup or get a kick out. It was executed well. The Sixers just missed. I don't know if this was designed, but you've got two attempts at a screen with one roll and one pop. The Sixers got creative trying to get the ball in Seth Curry's hands and get him free in space. Here, you see double drag screens where Seth Curry gets enough space to shoot and Embiid rolls, which disorganizes the defense. This is a low-key pin down and Embiid tries to seal Fred VanVleet. The pump fake freed Seth Curry and he drew a double team, which then generated a Ben Simmons layup. Next is a horn set look, but some people call this play Barcelona. The near side wing goes to the far side corner and Seth Curry sprints under the double screen. Freddie is hauling ass over the screens, but by the time he gets there, that's wet, coach! This is simple ball, but effective and a way to bust a zone. There's a 6'8 forward at the high post who gives it to a 7-foot big in the low post, and your help D ain't helping there, coach! Outside of play design, a lot of the Sixers' new offense revolves around pick and rolls and dribble handoffs. This is partially why, through the first week of the NBA season, the Sixers are top 10 in driving field goals attempted, and their pick and roll and handoff frequencies have increased from a season ago. On inbounds plays, we've predominantly seen stagger screens. Dwight flashes late to seal off the defender and give Shake enough room to shoot. Philadelphia used this baseline inbounds play a few times to get their shooters open in space.
Throughout the game, I made a few observations so you wouldn't have to.
Joe played really heads-up ball against Toronto. He identified double teams early enough to get a shot off or avoid turning it over. Late in the fourth, he demonstrated great awareness and delivered some huge game-deciding passes. Hold on, let me kick. One, two, three. It's five heads looking at Embiid and swarming to the ball. He dropped it in the basket for Curry, which sealed the entire game. You can sense floor spacing again when, at the time of the catch, Tobias Harris had four out, one in the post, and everybody was on the far side. I noticed a high handoff involving Ben Simmons, which is a creative way to get him downhill and give him a head start. My final observation was Philadelphia's ball movement. I thought the Sixers did a really nice job swinging the rock around the perimeter, which is important because there's a few shooters on this team that could really benefit from ball movement. The defensive scramble to close out and play help defense gives guys around the perimeter really clean looks.
Joel Embiid is on point this season, from the conditioning to the footwork to passing out of the post. I can't say enough good things about Embiid.
This was single-handedly the most important play of the game. Watch it again. Let me see if you can tell me why. No, it's not the Dwight Howard block. It's when Embiid decided he was cool to come back in. He did his thing again with 29 points, 16 rebounds, hey bro, that's water! Two steals and two blocks. But he checked back into the game with 4 minutes and a second in the third quarter, and basically decided the outcome. From that point on, he grabbed 9 rebounds, scored 11 points, and got a steal. His presence deterred a few Toronto shots, and he imposed his will so heavily that from the point he checked in the third quarter, the Sixers outscored Toronto 35-17.
Listen, bro, at this point, Ben is who Ben is, but I like the aggression.
Roll the Ben Simmons tape. Even he was okay. Nice little in and out, Ben. I was saying, even Ben was aggressive against the Raptors. He only made 3 shots from the floor, but you like that he took 11 attempts and you like that he took 8 free throw attempts.
I know, only 11 attempts? But these are the trials and tribulations of being a Simmons fan.
And again, we're gonna have to talk about Tobias Harris and his decision making, because I've seen great strides in the past 3 games.
When Tobias can get free in space to his spot, he's money! A lot of what you've seen from Tobias Harris in the previous 3 games, quick draw, bucket! Anyway, the previous 3 games is quicker decision making. Tobias dropped 26 points on 55% shooting from the field and pushed his catch and shoot 3 percentage to 43%. He is the second most catch and shoot threes on Philadelphia. Tobias doesn't try to be anybody he's not. And when he can get downhill and free in space to hit his spots, he's a really effective ball player.
Yeah, the Sixers might have overpaid Tobias, in your opinion, but you're not paying him. Like, let it go. Why are you so pressed?
When you let that go and see Tobias for who he is, you can appreciate his
game. And let me break down the defensive front real quick, because altogether there were some really good glimpses of team defense.
Danny Green runs into an Aaron Baines screen and hits the deck. Embiid steps up to take the Kyle Lowry shot away. Simmons, who comes over to play help defense, runs to close out when Pascal Siakam gets the pass. And then this dude, Danny Green, finally gets up and runs all the way to the other wing to close out on the 3-point shot. Here, Joel Embiid steps up to take a charge from OG Anunoby, turns around, and oh my God, you're a little boy. On this play, Dwight Howard is playing deny, okay? He runs all the way back to the basket to tag the roller or prevent the drive. Then out of nowhere, he runs all the way back to the wing and closes out on the 3-point shot. Ultimately, there was really good individual defensive efforts too. A couple of Sixers went under screens instead of playing on the hip of the ball handler and letting them walk into shots, and he didn't die. The Raptors missed the shots too. Tobias held it down numerous times against different assignments. Their length of pause. The Sixers' length around the perimeter and their multi-positional defensive versatility helps them match up against any opponent really well. And then there's also the Ben Simmons effect. Ben Simmons defended Pascal Siakam and Fred VanVleet for 30 combined possessions. And the two shot a combined 23% from the field and 16% from three. Oh my God. He also had 2 deflections, a steal, and a block.
But at the same time, there were plenty of defensive lapses. So, you know, Philadelphia's got some stuff to work on.
There's 5 of you in transition here, right? No one's gonna pick up Kyle Lowry? This happened 3 times. This can't happen with Kyle Lowry 3 times. From this vantage point, there's 3 defenders ahead of Kyle Lowry. Right here, it's 3 of you that could pick Kyle Lowry up. Nobody said stop, ball. You just let Kyle Lowry do that? Same thing in transition. It's 4 of you looking at Kyle Lowry. You're gonna let him do that to your defense? Keep an eye on Fred VanVleet. Do you see a defender near him or even on him? That's a problem. There was some miscommunication here which kept Fred VanVleet wide open this entire play. Obviously he's gonna hit that 3. There's some miscommunication on this OG Anunoby screen between Tobias Harris and Danny Green. Seth Curry sees it and signals for help, but OG shouldn't have gotten that 3 on this play. Yeah, this isn't gonna work either. Somebody's gotta get a hand up on their man.
All right, bro, that does it for me. I appreciate you guys hanging out with me. As always, I'll see you when I see you. And look, wait, 2021's what, a day away? 2 days away? In the new year, make sure you stay hydrated, stay moisturized, take care of your mental good energy, and most importantly, listen. Stay solid, baby! Stay solid, baby.